Hello and welcome back. I am Dr. Slaughter, and today we are going to be talking about how to use InfraNodus to improve our classroom lectures. InfraNodus is a very powerful tool for textual analysis, and few texts in a classroom are more important than a professor's lectures. In our last video, we engaged in sentiment analysis. We took a look at what our students thought about an assignment on ethics, and used the emotional valence of their text to derive discussion questions and useful classroom insights. Today, however, we are not interested in sentiment analysis and are instead going to engage in structural analysis. In every lecture, there are good, well-written sections that nicely dovetail into the overall course objectives. And, speaking from my own experience, there are always parts of a lecture that are not quite explicitly connected to the rest of the content. While I do my best to provide a holistic approach to course subjects, it can be difficult to understand how all of this content connects. These sorts of gaps are where we can lose students, both in terms of attention and in terms of comprehension. Today, we're going to take a look at how InfraNodus can help us to discover, analyze, and fill in any gaps in our lecture material. I'm going to be using my lecture on actor network theory as an example today. As per usual, the first step is always uploading our data into InfraNodus. Now, I tend to write out my lectures word for word, so I have a script ready for uploading. Okay, now that we have our data loaded into InfraNodus, we should see our graph. Again, don't think too much about the graph right now. I know that seeing all of this data visualized can be a little overwhelming. Let's go over the top right side of the screen and click the little button that looks like a bar graph. This is going to open the Discourse Analytics panel. Last time, we took a look at the main ideas of the document in the AI Insights section. Today, though, we are more interested in the button titled Content Gaps. Go ahead and click that now. Okay, now this is interesting. InfraNodus says that there is a structural gap in my lecture between Bruno Latour's actor network theory and the open source software movement. While I do discuss both of these topics in my lecture, I will have to admit, they are not particularly well-connected concepts in my work. That said, it is important for me to have my students understand the connections between actor network theory and open source software. InfraNodus has identified this gap, but what can it help do to bridge it? As it turns out, InfraNodus can provide quite an array of resources for making lectures more readily understandable and coherent. Let's see what InfraNodus makes of the gap in my lecture between the actor network theory and open source software sections. In the Concept Gaps tab, we can go down below to the Topics to Connect to access the AI features. There's a small purple button below Topics to Connect that reads AI Question. Pressing this button will generate a question that is designed to bridge the gap between these two less related concepts. For example, last time I received the following response. How do the principles of actor network theory elucidate the formation and dynamics of open source communities, its infrastructural publics capable of political action? This is a very useful discussion question and asks the students to think about how different parts of my lecture are interconnected. Similarly, these insights can be useful for pedagogical practitioners, as it allows us to review and revise our lectures for greater understanding and coherence. It can be difficult for teachers to receive good, objective feedback on our classroom activities, and InfraNodus provides a valuable lens for understanding how we are understood. In fact, if we look just a little lower on the screen, we can see a section entitled Conceptual Gateways. Let's say that we are trying to teach your students how to think critically. I am always trying to encourage critical thinking in my classroom, and I imagine that you have similar priorities. In these cases, sometimes we do not want to simply tell our students that two topics are connected. Rather, we want them to think about the relationship between the two topics and to hypothesize possible connections. This is what the Conceptual Gateway section is useful for. While the Topics to Connect section provides a direct and efficient way to connect any two disparate parts of a lecture, the Conceptual Gateways section has a much gentler approach. Let's go ahead and press the purple AI question button underneath Conceptual Gateways. Now, Since I will get a different question with every generation, I might not have the same question today as I will the next time I press it. So the question generated today is, how can actor network theory enhance our understanding of infrastructural publics and open source communities, and citizen science by uncovering the roles of human and non-human actants in fostering an interconnected network? While the topics to discuss section is excellent for identifying aspects of a lecture that could use fixing, the conceptual gateways section is useful for identifying areas that could provide particularly fruitful classroom discussions. I always like to say that InfraNodus is a tool to think with you, not a tool that thinks for you. InfraNodus is excellent at discovering gaps in discourse, but what you choose to do with that gap is entirely up to you. Not every gap can be bridged. Not every gap should be bridged. But a gap, once identified, has potential. Some gaps, like the Grand Canyon, invite awe without really encouraging bridge building. Other gaps, like the gaps between the slats on a monkey bar, allow for the possibility of play. Not all gaps are meant to be bridged, but all gaps, once properly identified, have possibilities, affordances. Like any powerful tool, InfraNodus presents you with choices. Will you use this capability to shore up weaknesses in your lecture material, crafting a comprehensive and holistic presentation? Or will you instead see these structural gaps as opportunities, as a chance to observe your students engaging in critical thinking and the building of conceptual bridges? While this case study is pedagogically focused, I firmly believe that these approaches are generalizable. Can you think of any use cases where understanding gaps in content might be useful to you? Feel free to leave a response down in the comments. I have been Dr. Slaughter, and tune in next time where we will be discussing how to use InfraNodus as an academic administrator.